Hello everyone, welcome back. Severed is here, coming back with a new series, and it shall be What If Deku Was Xiao? Now, like you guys of course voted, I'm gonna go with Xiao, just like you voted in the last video. Well, don't forget to like, subscribe, and let's get right into it. As where we can first start off, is like 1 week before the last day of middle school. Izuku and all of his class is right now inside the bus, and they are going into a museum just to learn a little bit about dinosaurs. As after they finally got into the museum, everyone just going down the bus, and the teacher starts telling everyone, "Well, student, today we will gonna look into some ancient creature from a long time, from like millions of years. Of course, we will gonna today see the exoskeletons of some dinosaurs, and we will gonna learn a couple of an old species of dinosaurs. So, everyone, come with me." As the teacher starts taking everyone into a little trip around the place, in the end, Izuku starts feeling some weird gust of winds hitting his face. As he stops in his place while everyone starts continue just walking away, Izuku looking on his left, he see that the wind coming from inside the room. As Izuku said, how is it even possible for the wind to come from inside the room? That if there is wasn't any kind of a window open there? As Izuku just feeling the gust of wind hitting him, his face even stronger than before, as Izuku said, "Alright, what the hell is happening there?" As Izuku after that go inside, as he just go even inside the museum, and in the end, he see two weird things behind the glass. One of them being a weird mask, and the other one being a weird looking stone like this. As Izuku seeing this, he said, "Wow, this is so beautiful." As he starts reading the, you know, of course the papers that in front of the two pieces, as he said, "This is the vision of cryo, the power of the wind. It was once holded by the ancient god that, what is it? What's that name? This is really a weird name, but anyways, this power has been given into humans as a vision, a power to control the elements. Cryo is one of the other couple of ones, which is Geo, Electro, and Pyro, and Cryo. And a couple other ones. The power to control winds has been once holded by an ancient warrior that named Xiao. He was a warrior that has gone inside the War of the Archons, being forced to do things that he refused to do, but he couldn't do anything about it." As Izuku, you know, looking on the mask and reading the description, he just see the mask of the conqueror of demons, once wielded by the legendary warrior Xiao, one of the ancient warrior of Japan. He was named by his ruthlessness and his very, very kills, you know, very, very strong power and lots of kills. He also was wearing this mask against in every fight. He never used it in anything else. This mask was being the symbol of fear for anyone that once tried to do some bad things in their lives." As Izuku just looking on the mask, and after that he continued reading the description, he said, "The legend said that one day a new conqueror of demons will be chosen to wield this ancient mask, and he will gonna be forced to do things that he never wanted to do, to become something that he doesn't want to be, to do things for other people that he doesn't want to work for. He will gonna feel a massive pain, the same pain that the ancient conqueror of demons once felt." As Izuku just reading all of this, he said, "Wow, what a nonsense. Seriously, who would believe this?" And after that, Izuku just turned around, as he immediately being pushed into the ground by a strong gust of wind hitting his back. As Izuku said, "What the?" And after that, he see the mask. He said, "What the hell? How did you?" As the mask start to glow, and Izuku said, "Wait, what's happening?" as he go to touch the glass, but immediately after that, the teacher come from the door saying, "Midoriya, what are you doing here?" As Izuku said, "Oh, sorry, mister, teacher, I was just..." "Midoriya, let's go." After that, the teacher said, "Alright, Midoriya, let's go." As Izuku go back with the other students. In the end, everyone just left the place. Izuku go back into his home, telling hello to his mother and going to his room. And after that, sitting on his desk, as he starts searching on the internet about Xiao, as he starts looking into some files of an ancient warrior that once was called the Conqueror of Demons. In the end, he find a couple of information, but not a lot. As Izuku said, "Weird. And that weird thing about choosing a new conqueror? I doesn't really know what that means, but maybe I just should not focus on it a lot. I only have 1 week left for my middle school to end it, so I need to start training to become a hero." As after that, Izuku go on his bed and start sleeping. In the middle of the night, he start feeling something on his face as Izuku start touching his face and said, "What the hell? What the hell is this?" As after that, Izuku stand up, start feeling his face. He feel something on his face as he tried to take it off, but said, "What the? What is this?" As he look into the mirror, he see the mask, the same mask that he saw in the museum on his face as Izuku tried to take it off, but more that he try, more the pain that getting even stronger and stronger. In the end, Izuku start falling on the ground, and after that, he start trying much more harder and harder to take the mask off, but in the end, he said, "I need to take it off! Just go off!" As after that, Izuku immediately taking the mask off, ripping his face with it, as his face start, you know, just to drip blood, and after that, he suddenly waking up from his sleep and said, "What the hell? What was that?" As Izuku start touching his face and start feeling it, looking into the mirror, he said, "Whoa, that was a weird nightmare. Damn it. That was really scary." And after that, Izuku starts rubbing his face with his hand as he saw something weird on his hand, as he said, "What the?" As he look on his arm, he see that something on his wrist looking like this, the same weird looking stone that he saw in the museum is still on his wrist, as Izuku said, "Wait, did I stole this? Why is it on my wrist?" As Izuku tried to take it off, but it's not just not going off, as Inko start knocking on the door saying, "Izuku, is everything okay?" "Yes, mom, everything okay. Everything is just perfect fine. I'm good. I'm just gonna go out a couple of seconds now. Just don't, please." As Inko said, "Alright, Izuku, just calm down a little bit." As Izuku said, "Alright, mom." After that, Izuku go out and start, you know, hiding his arm from Inko, going into the, of course, none other than the little, you know, I forgot the fucking name, the bathroom, yes. And he start washing his face as he just looking on his wrist, seeing the weird thing, as he said, "So when did I even got this?" As he tried to take it off, but more that he tries, more that it just refuses, as right now is just not glowing at all, as Izuku said, "Weird." As after that, he just go out of his room, or, you know, from the little bathroom, and immediately eat the breakfast with his mom. As Inko said, "Alright, Izuku, are you gonna go into your school today?" As Izuku said, I mean, of course I'm gonna go. "Well, see you afternoon, mom." As Inko said, "Alright, Izuku, have a good day." As Izuku just get out of his room, or, you know, the house, and go into the school. In the end, he go into the school, everything is just going normal. As the day of the school ended, Bakugo still bullying Izuku, nothing much. In the end, Izuku go outside and start feeling the wind hitting his face, while he just walking down the street, going to back into his house, as Izuku start feeling the wind hitting his face, as Izuku said, "What is happening?" And after that, Izuku start walking towards where the wind is coming from, as In the end, he got into the forest, as right now he's in the middle of the forest, and said, "Alright, where's that wind is coming from?" As after that, Izuku said, "Wait a minute, did I lost myself here?" As Izuku starts running in all direction, but he doesn't find anything. As he said, "Hello, is anyone here? Any hunters, anything? Man, today was just so stupid to follow a fucking wind." Damn it. As Izuku starts seeing some glowing on his hand, as Izuku looking on his left hand wrist and seeing the weird looking stone glowing, as Izuku said, "What the?" As he pointed in one of the direction, the stone suddenly just loses its colors, and immediately Izuku starts moving into another direction as the stone starts glowing higher and higher. As Izuku says, "So this is some sort of a tracker?" As Izuku starts following there. Where is that? Of course, the stone is taking him. In the end, he finally got into a weird cave. As Izuku got inside the cave and start walking, but the cave is just so dark. As Izuku said, "This place is so dark. Why is it this dark?" As the only thing that's keeping him able to see what's in front of him, or at least, you know, just to see himself, is the stone that's glowing. In the end, Izuku starts seeing a light in the end of the tunnel as he starts running in, and immediately after that, he's being blinded, and after that, he just smashed into something. As Izuku opened his eyes, he look in front of him. He see that he suddenly just go back into the same museum. As Izuku said, "What the? Why am I here now?" As he look in front of him, he see the mask still inside the, of course, the glass box. And looking on the, you know, the right side of the mask, seeing that the other, of course, the other glass box doesn't have the stone inside of it. As Izuku said, "So how did I even manage to steal it? And why did I even steal it? I'm sure that I didn't do it." As after that, the mask suddenly starts to glow. Izuku said, "Do you want me to touch it?" As Izuku just taking off the glass box from the mask, and he go closer to touch it and said, "Alright." And after that, he just touched the mask, as the mask immediately launched himself back into Izuku's face. As Izuku start feeling a massive pain, he starts screaming on the top of his lungs and trying to take it off. But in the end, the guards start coming into the place, as they said, "What the hell? What's happening here?" As they see in front of him a kid that right now with a black hair and some blue on his hair just on the ground, and a weird looking black and blue aura surrounding him, wearing the mask and the little stone on his wrist. As the guard said, "Kid, take off the mask." As Izuku's just screaming in pain higher and higher, the guards start to put their hands on their ears to protect their, you know, their ears from getting hurt. In the end, Izuku put his hand on the mask and said, "I need to take it off." As after that, he just tripped the mask off of his face. As after that, blood split everywhere, and the guards just seeing Izuku without his skin on his face, as the guard said, "Oh my god, kid, what have you?" As after that, Izuku just looking at them, smiling while his face is just filled with blood. In the end, Izuku said, "Pain, what a stupid joke." And after that, one of the guards getting his gun out and starts shooting on Izuku. Izuku immediately, after that, he just go into the right, literally dashing into the right, as the police the guards said, "What the?" As Izuku immediately dash into the guard and got hold of his neck, as he smash him into the ground and immediately starts smashing him again and again, while the other guards telling Izuku to stop. As he's Izuku looking back at him, still face filled with blood and his eyes just glowing with yellow, as Izuku looking at him and said, "Oh, are you gonna shoot a kid? I doesn't believe that you will do it." As the guards, you know, his hands shaking, while Izuku starts standing up and going closer and closer, as he put his head into the barrel of the gun, as he said, "Come on, shoot the gun." Shoot it! Shoot it! Come on! Show me that you are can do it! You can do it! Come on, I believe in you! As the guard said, you are crazy! As Izuku said, yeah, maybe. And after that, Izuku just got hold of the gun and break the guard arm. And after that, he just threw the gun away after breaking it into pieces. As he said, alright, see you around, boys. As after that, he go back into the mask. As he got hold of it and put it back on his face, as he said, see you around, demons. As after that, Izuku suddenly just disappeared out of sight. As the guards, both of them still alive, as after that, they start calling the police, telling that someone has stole the mask and the stone of the warrior Xiao. As after that, everyone starts coming into this scene from police officers and everyone else. While that happening, Izuku right now in an alleyway, as suddenly he's just standing in the middle of the alleyway and suddenly the mask just disappeared off of his face. As Izuku start breathing heavily after falling on the ground saying, what the hell was that now? What was that? As Izuku start touching his face, he feel his face normal. As Izuku said, what was that? It's just the last thing that I remember. I was in front of the mask. And after that, as Izuku said, where is the mask now? And where am I? And after that, Izuku just looking left to right. He see no one. He doesn't see the mask. He doesn't see anything. He just, the only thing that he can see is that weird stone on his wrist. As Izuku said, what are you? What is happening with me? And after that, Izuku said, I need to go back into my mom. As he just leave the place, and immediately after that, he just go back into his house. In the end, Inku just seeing Izuku, telling him hello Izuku and everything. In the end, after that, Izuku taking a deep breath and said, alright Izuku, just calm down. Everything is alright. Everything is alright. As in the end, he go into his school in the next day after going back into his home. As right now he is in the school, sitting down, and after that, a couple of classes goes by, as the teacher go out of the class because he has been called. As the students are just inside, the teacher come back into the class and said, well student, looks like that the museum that we gone into the last couple of days has been stolen by a weird kid. He was wearing a school uniform and the police are right now searching for him. So we have his fingerprints. The police will right now gonna try to see if any of your footprint, fingerprints are match the one that they have. Don't worry, kids. It's not a very big deal. As the police just come in, and of course the chief of police and the detective come into the class. They start to see everyone, fingerprints. In the end, Izuku putting his, right hand fingerprints, as suddenly is just taking a match, as the chief of police said it matched. As the detective Izuku said, wait, what? As the other students looking on Izuku saying, wait, Deku stealing something? He can't even, he's quirkless, that's impossible. As the detective said, kid, what were you doing in the last night? As Izuku said, I was in the forest. I just was in the forest, and as I just suddenly just lost consciousness. As the detective said, seriously, that's your excuse, kid? Losing consciousness in the middle of the forest? Try to take something better. Well, if you're really not gonna admit it, how about this? As the two guards of the museum come into the class and sit, and they looking around, they see Izuku, as they said, well, he kinda reminding me of it. Wait a second. As he got hold of his left arm and seeing that, the stone on his left arm, as he said, this is the kid, he must be him. He stole the stone and the mask, as Izuku said. Wait, this can't be. I didn't steal anything, as... After that, the chief of police was about to put the quirk-canceling device on Izuku's arm. But before that happened, Izuku, you know, tried to push them away. After that, Izuku said, please just let me explain, as all of a sudden a strong gust of wind coming out of Izuku's arms and throwing the chief of police and the detective and the two other guards away. The chief of police said, for the police, we find the comrades, or, you know, we find the person that stole the mask. He's right now inside the school. Come in! As the police out of the school starts coming in, Izuku starts running out of the class while the police are, you know, running after him. Izuku in the end going out to, you know, standing in outside of the school as he see in front of him some heroes and some police officers as they said, kid, give up right now and give us the mask and the stone. As Izuku said, please, I didn't do anything. I really didn't. As all of a sudden, Izuku being teleported away as... You know, the hero Death Arms said, what the? He teleported away? What is that, Kid Quark? As after that, the chief of police come out and said, did you got him? No, he ran away. He teleported away. As the chief of police said, damn it. Damn it. Well, at least we know who are we gonna follow. Let's go inside and ask the school about who that kid is. As the chief of police and everyone else going inside the school to ask, taking some information about Izuku, and they got, you know, the coordinates of his mother house. While that happening, Izuku right now on the other side of the city, being teleported as he taking a deep breath, saying, what happened? How did I? As all of a sudden, the mask being morphed on Izuku's face, and he immediately lost consciousness as he wake up in a black void, and Izuku said, where am I? What's this place? As Izuku hearing a voice from behind saying, come down, there is nothing you should be scared of. I'm not gonna hurt you. As Izuku looking behind, he see a weird looking guy. He seemed like a kid with a glowing yellow eyes and a black with some, you know, with some blue on there in his hair. As Izuku seeing this kid just crossing his hand together, Izuku said, who are you? Wait. I saw you before. You are... Yes, you are right. I am, as you humans call me, the conqueror of demons, or Xiao. I was really disappointing when I find out that the mask has chose you to decide the fate of the world. As Izuku said, wait, the fate of what? As Xiao said, listen here. You have one of the visions, right? As... you know, Izuku said, visions, as Xiao said, do you have the first one? As Izuku said, do you mean this? As Xiao seeing the, you know, the stone in Izuku's arm and said, perfect, that's one, still a couple more to go. As Izuku said, wait, what are you talking about? As Xiao starts saying, alright, let me tell you the story. Now, I am Xiao, the conqueror of demons, the villain in Yaksha. And you are wearing my mask. My mask has chose you to be the next one. To be the one that will gonna decide the fate of this world. This world will gonna go into a war and into destruction. And you are the only one that can stop it. And the only way that you will be able to stop it is by stealing the other visions. You have the... Right now you have the cryo. You still need the pyro. And Electro and Geo and the other couple of ones. Now, you will gonna be able to find the others by just following the signal in your own stone of, in your own vision. Just follow the light where it's taking you and you will gonna find the visions. When you find all of them, make sure to stop there. Make sure to use them in the right way so you will be able to stop the end of the world. As Izuku said, wait, you're not explaining anything. Why are you choosing me? I'm quirkless. I'm weak. As Xiao said, I know that. You're weak. You're worthless. You're nothing but a scum. You're just basically something that I'm really disgusting in. You are everything that the humans ever have made wrong. Weakness. Scary. A pussycat. Just basically worthless brat. But if my mask has chose you, that means that you have something special. Something that you will gonna be able to use it, so it will gonna help you in the end to be able to collect the visions. Now, make sure to use my power very well. I'm gonna train you every now and then when you are in sleep to teach you a couple of my tricks. Now, go back into the real world and don't go back into your human, into your mother house. The police will gonna be there, I'm sure of it. Try to search for some place to hide in, or maybe go into the forest. Understand? As Izuku said, wait a second, but before he managed to do anything, Izuku being pulled out of his, you know, headspace, as Izuku taking a deep breath and seeing the mask in front of him on the ground and said, what the hell is that now? As Izuku seeing the mask suddenly disappeared and he said, that was Xiao? Is his soul stuck in this mask? Chose me? What is he talking about? But maybe he's right. Maybe I should not go back into my mother house. The police will gonna be there. But I really didn't steal it. Damn it. Let's just go into the forest. As Izuku, after that, just stand up and go into the forest. And this one gonna leave it off, guys. Don't forget to like, subscribe, comment down below. Tell me what you think about this part. And what do you think will gonna happen in the next part? Well, I have nothing more to say than Severed was here.